In today's video, I'll show you where to download anime characters' 3D models, quickly rig and assign animations to them, then make a simple anime shader inside Blender. The workflow is optimized to efficiently create a dynamic crowd with diverse variations in a short amount of time. You probably already know that you can speed up your workflow by downloading 3D models and texture assets online. Even though I can model and texture my own assets, I often download 3D assets when time is tight, like during contests with deadlines. While downloaded assets might not always be perfect and require adjustments, they can still save you a lot of time. Let's go over how we'll approach this. Here's the plan. First, download your 3D character model and texture. Then we'll rig and animate using an auto rigger. After that, we'll apply a cel shader. Repeat the process for additional characters. First, let's walk through where to download and how you should use the asset. While platforms like Sketchfab have a vibrant 3D artist community with a good variety of models, finding anime-style assets can still feel like searching for a needle in a haystack. Other sites like CG Trader and TurboSquid often come with steep prices, and you're pretty much stuck if you're specifically looking for anime-style models. This is why, when it comes to finding anime-style assets, one of my go-to methods is using ripped 3D models. These models are extracted from video games data. However, remember that these models are the work of other artists and often belong to game studios. I recommend using them solely for learning and educational purposes, not for commercial use, as this area is legally and ethically complex. To find these assets, head to DeviantArt, navigate to the XNALara section, or use the link in the description. This section is packed with 3D assets to explore. Once you've located a character you like, download it. Most of the time, they're free. Also, a bit of a warning. In this space, you will find a lot of not safe for work content. So browse with caution. You will need to unzip the file you downloaded. These files are called XPS asset. To open them in Blender, you'll need an add-on called XNALaraMesh. Use the link provided to download and install the XNALara add-on. After installation, go to the import section in Blender, select the XNALara format, navigate to your asset folder, and choose your asset. The model will load complete with its bone system, ready for your modifications. So, how to use this? From this point, you have several options. You can set up a control rig and animate manually. This is the most straightforward approach and provides the most customizable animations. However, it's also the most time-consuming since you'll be building the animation from scratch. You can also use an auto-rigger and add pre-made animations, remove the existing rig, and create a new one using auto-rigging software. Then, add pre-made animations. This is the quickest method but limits the ability to customize the animation. It's a great choice for background characters where quantity is more important than unique animation quality. This is the approach I'll focus on in this tutorial. Another hybrid approach is to retarget existing animations, then fine-tune by making adjustments. Retargeting involves transferring existing animations, for example from mocap data, to your character, allowing for quick adjustments and customization without starting from scratch. This is ideal for creating custom animations efficiently. I use this technique for my main character's animation in the Kinetic Rush Challenge using the character control system in Maya, but you can also achieve similar results in Blender. I'll link tutorials for both Maya and Blender in the description. Now, let's go over how to use an auto rigger to add pre-made animations. We'll also do some preparation in advance. The two most common auto riggers are Mixamo and AccuRig. The process on both platforms is quite similar, though each has its own pros and cons. I'll demonstrate how to use both. Back in Blender, for the purpose of this tutorial, You won't need the existing bone system from the asset, even if it's good quality. We'll save that topic for another time. Select the geometry of your character, press Alt-P, and choose Clear Parent to detach the bones. Next, select all the geometry and export them as an FBX file. You can then import this file into Mixamo or AccuRig to proceed with auto-rigging. We'll start with Mixamo. Go to mixamo.com. Everything should be free here, and you'll just need to create an account. So go ahead and register, then log in. Click Upload Character and select your FBX file. After a brief wait, you'll be prompted to place markers on your character's chin, wrists, elbows, knees, and groin. These markers help the auto-rigger generate a suitable rig for your character. Once done, click Next. The rigging process will take a moment. Afterward, review the rigging quality by previewing the character's movements. Click Next to proceed to the animation selection. For this example, I'll choose a simple idle animation. It will automatically apply to your character and you can preview it instantly. After that, click Download, choose your desired frame rate, and click Download again. You'll receive an FBX file that you can import directly into your 3D software. So back to Blender, go to File, Import, and choose FBX. Then select your FBX file that you just downloaded, and you should have a 3D model with animation applied. Next, we'll use AccuRig. To get started, download the AccuRig app and create an account. Links are in the description. Once installed, open the app, log in, and import your FBX file. The process is similar to Mixamo, but offers more control over rig details, including finger, feet, shoulder, and more. This setup takes a bit longer, but helps minimize errors, especially with tricky parts like fingers. After setting up, you can preview the rig quality. Next, you need to upload the rigged character to the cloud by hitting Upload to Actor Core. You can view the actor in your Actor Core account, then add animations by searching in the Actor Core library. Basic animations like idle are often free, and you can preview it instantly. You can then click Download, select your character, choose the frame rate and target software, in this case Blender, and click Download again. Download the zipped file and unzip it. In Blender, import both FBX files. Since ActorCore separates the skinned mesh and the animation, you'll need to transfer the animation data. Select the armature of the skinned mesh, then the armature with the animation. Press Ctrl L and choose Copy Animation Data. And that's it. Your character is now animated. As you can see, AccuRig involves a few more steps compared to Mixamo, but it offers greater control over the details. Depending on your needs and how unique you want your character's animations to be, you can choose the option that best fits your project. The next step is to apply shader. Now it's time to render your character so it actually looks like anime. And for that, you need to create a cel shader. Your character shader consists of two elements, color and value. We'll start with color. In Blender's shader editor, delete the principled BSDF, drop your texture inside, and combine it with a color adjustment node in case you need to tweak the hue, saturation, and brightness to match your scene mood. Next, value. This can be broken down to shadow, or sometimes highlight, depending on the lighting setup. Make sure you have a sunlight source in your scene to control shadows and highlights effectively. In the shader editor, combine diffuse BSDF, shader to RGB, and the color ramp. Adjust the color ramp's mode to define how sharp or soft the shadow should be. I choose constant to create a sharp shadow. Use a mixed color node to blend this with your texture. From there, you can choose to make changes to the shadow's color or its opacity. Once done, you can copy the node's setup to other materials. Just remember to make the necessary adjustments, as different colors may require fine-tuning. The last touch is adding outlines. Outlines can help replicate the 2D drawing style often seen in anime. I'll show you a quick and hassle-free method using the Solidify modifier. Select your geometry, go to the Modifiers panel, and add a Solidify modifier. Set the thickness to a negative value, then check Flip Normal. This creates a shell around your geometry that's flipped inside out. You'll need a material for this outline, so create a new material and set its color to black. Enable backface culling in the material settings. In the Solidify modifier, set the material offset to 1, which tells Blender to use the second material in the list for the outline. If you want a subtler outline, set the material's blend mode to alpha blend and adjust the alpha. For Blender 4.2, set the render method to blended. Repeat the process to other geometries, and that's it. You now have an animated character with anime shading and outlines that mimic the look of 2D art. From here, you can manually place them in your scene, or one of my favorite approaches is to use particle systems to create crowds. So have fun and experiment a bit. Feel free to explore different camera angles or movements and play around with the focal length. Sometimes even small adjustments can make a big difference in the final result. I hope you found the tutorial helpful and enjoyable. If you have any questions or want to share your creations, please leave a comment below or reach out to me on social media. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you won't miss any future videos. Until next time, keep creating and have fun with your art.